What's going on, guys? Welcome back to NCAA Football 14 Road to Glory as week number 11 is finally here for the 7-1 Cincinnati Bearcats taking on the conference-leading SMU Mustangs. SMU Southern Methodist University 4-3 on the season, 3-0 in the conference, only undefeated team left. We're trying to give them that first loss here in week number 11. Now, the awards are starting to be put together, the award list. So you see here the Maxwell Award is Taylor Martinez behind him, Jordan Lynch, Derek Carr, Braxton Miller. Taking a look at the Walker Camp Award, it's senior quarterback Jordan Lynch. Almost 3,000 yards combined on the year. And you see me all the way down there at number 9, but not for the Biletnikoff. I'm leading things off, 68 receptions, barely over 1,000 yards, 14 touchdowns behind me. Mike Evans, Burst, Coleman, Ward, Matt Miller, Boise State. And then we'll look at the best returner. We're not going to look at all the awards, but check me out. I'm in here at number 4. And everyone else above me, I'm pretty sure most of the people behind me already have a touchdown, either via a punt or a just regular kick return. I've got to get my speed up so I can take one back before the end of the year, because if that glitch is still around, then I can't return kicks in my sophomore season. But looking at the matchup between the Mustangs and the Bearcats, I mean, our offense, 13th in points per game, and we're pretty much expected to walk away with a win here in week 11, but we all know that isn't the case. Shout out to USF for beating us in that close game earlier in the season, but here we are getting started, trying to extend our win streak to 5 games. We're on a 4-game win streak heading into week 11, and here we are getting started as Brendan K incomplete pass going left side for Anthony McClung, and that's how this game will start. We'll come to the field, 2nd and 10, pistol set. Brendan K drops back the pass. He's going to take off the run up the middle of the field, and Brendan K hit hard after a gain of 4 yards. You have to slide. We can't lose our starting quarterback here against Southern Methodist. That's not a good deal. So here goes K firing right side on 3rd and 6, finding an open man. That's going to be Abernathy, who was completely open after just running a short route, just sitting right underneath the defense, caught the pass, got the first down and more. And that's going to get us down to about the 45-yard line as we'll go pistol set once again, a read option carry outside for Brendan K to the right side of the field, taking the safety out of the play. Brendan K down the field, and K down inside the 25-yard line. That carry good for 31 yards. This is why I like Brendan K. He has the speed, but that the block by the receivers on the right side, the offensive linemen. I mean, look at 79 just destroying people. That's 2 people on the same play. Later in the drive, it's 3rd down and 3. K drops back, fires right side. This one's caught by Anthony McClung for a 9-yard first down reception. That's going to make this 1st and goal at about the 6-yard line. Later in the drive, it's 3rd and goal as K drops back the pass, trying to find someone open down the field, but brought down, and we will end up having to settle for 3, and we're not going to get it. 0-0 ball game here in the first quarter as K drops back the pass once again, fires left side for Chris Moore, had a man open in the flat on the right, the running back, and completely ignored him. It's going to be 2nd and 7, 2 minutes left here in the first quarter as we go up the middle with Abernathy on the carry. That one good for 5, making it 3rd down and 2. So a big 3rd down here, trying to keep the drive alive. First quarter's almost wrapped up. Going up the middle, Abernathy with the carry. He finds 3 yards, good enough for the first. And this drive will continue as we're approaching the, pretty much we're at the 40-yard line right now. K's going to drop back once again, fires short. This one's caught by Chris Moore running across the middle. That short route across the middle has been working so far. That's good for 6 yards, 2nd and 4. I'm moving in motion this time, running across the middle of the field. This one is caught, and that'll get us down to about the 25-yard line. First reception of the game is good for 10 yards, finally getting me involved. 3rd and 3. We've been going to this place so many times in this game as I'm going to try to get to the corner of the end zone. And K up the middle barely gets the first down. That carry good for 5 yards, but you have to slide. That's 2 big hits on K here in this game as he'll drop back the pass, running across the middle of the field again, taking another big hit. That's going to be good for 5 yards. And I'm going to make this 3rd and 5. We can't get the first down without scoring a touchdown. So that'll make it 1st and goal. At about the 4-yard line, if we can get it, as K fires across the middle of the field and is caught by Anthony McClung for the first score of the game. Brendan K with a laser to Anthony McClung running the slant route coming from the left, but he could have gone over the middle to Chris Moore as SMU brought a blitz, but a nice throw by K. Nice job by McClung holding onto the football, and that'll get us a 7-0 lead. Back on the field in the second quarter at the 45-yard line. Clock is running. 1st and 10, shotgun set. K drops back. I have single coverage running up the field, but K tries to run. He's going to find 1 yard avoiding the sack, but I'm like, hey, you got to give me a chance in one-on-one coverage. Sometimes it gets picked. Sometimes it's a really big play. Let's hope I can bring this one in for a big-time catch across the top. 2nd and 9. K fires this one downfield in the air. This one is caught, getting us down to the 11-yard line. Gain of 32. That's a big-time catch. Later in the drive, ball at the 10-yard line, second and nine, screen pass caught outside, and this one will get about 2 yards. Is able to make this third down and seven, a rare time that play actually works for us, but a third and seven as I'm pulled off the field. KO drop back, going to the corner for Chisholm, and Chisholm can't hold on to the football. This was such a nice throw by K, right on the money. Nice route by Chisholm, but just can't bring it in over the shoulder. That's fundamentals. That's peewee football right there. Incomplete pass. We'll have to settle for three once again, and this time we will get it. So a 10-0 lead in the first half. Still plenty of time as we have the ball at midfield. 1:15 left. K trying to run as he's going to get sacked. Had a man wide open in the flat and decided not to throw the ball to him. So a 5-wide set here on 2nd and 13. K drops back again, trying to run up the middle. And this time, K is brought down for no gain. 3rd down and 13, I'm coming. We call a timeout. We have one left here in this first half. Pass caught to the outside, crossing the 40, getting inside the 35-yard line, and down to about the 33-34 for Bearcats' first down. We'll come to the field 1st and 10. Shotgun set, going 4-wide, slant across the middle of the field. Is caught for a first down, picking up 14 yards. As we get down to the 20, and we'll go right back to the no huddle, trying to exploit this hole in the zone that SMU has. Can I get this pass and run it in for the touchdown? K taking a while to call the play. It's 1st and 10 at the 20. K drops back the pass, has me open again, but this time doesn't throw the ball in my direction, as I was even more open this time than I was on the last play. He settles outside for a 5-yard completion to Chris Moore. Does stop the clock, so here we are, 2nd and 5 at the 15-yard line. As K's firing inside for Chris Moore again, and Chris Moore down to the 1-yard line, laying on the back of a defender but can't get up, or just rolling to the end zone for the touchdown. And here we are, 14 seconds left, and we are not running the football for some reason. We're passing as K's going to fire inside. This one's caught for the touchdown, and the late hit by the lineman. Are you serious? 9 seconds on the clock, and that late hit by the defensive lineman. We'll look at this play one more time. I mean, just running inside. I mean, SMU's playing too deep. You brought a bad blitz. You brought a zone blitz. That's even worse. And then I get hit late, and there's no flag. So SMU gets the ball first in the second half. Doesn't do anything with it. Here we are, 2nd and 6, past midfield. Doing a great job on these punt returns here in the game, as this one's going to be a carry outside for Abernathy. Good for the first down. And that will get us down to about the 35-yard line. Canner center here on the play, moving in motion to the inside of the formation. Going to be running up the field, trying to go to the empty spot in the zone. And this pass is underthrown and intercepted by the linebacker. K, that's a terrible pass. That's our first turnover of the game. We have to eliminate these turnovers, but luckily for us, our defense keeps SMU to 3 points. So here we are, 1st down and 10, under a minute left in the third quarter. Javon Harrison, fifth-string receiver, with a 15-yard completion. 23 seconds left, 2nd down and 6, ball at the 40-yard line, moving in motion once again. This pass thrown short, caught across the middle. As I'm running up the field, getting down to about the 50-yard line, completion good for 11 yards, as I have 132 on the game. Fourth quarter getting underway here, 2nd down and 10. K's going to drop back, and K's trying to run outside, and he's sacked for a loss of 9 yards. What in the world was he thinking on this play? Run up the middle of the field where you have the advantage, but trying to run outside and running into the back of his own tackle. And that's going to bring up 3rd down and 19. So running inside, they give me a free release down the field, and then I find the hole in the zone, but I can't get to the pass in time. It's incomplete, 4th down and 19. And we actually get the ball back later in the drive with better field position as this pass is caught. 7-yard completion down to the 3 or 4 yard line, 1st down and goal. Moving in motion on this play once again, K under center, 2 tight ends set. SMU draws back in coverage, but the hole across the middle of the field is left open once again. Touchdown, 2nd of the game. And oh, check me out, busting out the cooking dance. Let me not get cursed by Lil B. Let me make sure the base guy's okay with me busting out this cooking dance. Is it okay with you, Little B, if I use this cooking dance? I got approval. It's all good. 24-3 lead in the fourth quarter. That's going to pretty much do it for SMU, as this game is still going offensively for us. We are not giving up yet. This pass is caught as he was trying to go outside for Blake Annan, and that one's caught for 7 yards, and you guys will not believe it. I have 15 completions on today's game, breaking my record from earlier this season of 14 receptions. Can I break it one more time? We'll have to find out. 3 minutes left, 2nd down and 6 after the incomplete pass. K cutting up the middle of the field on the speed option. Good idea not pitching the football. That makes it 3rd down and 2. We'll go triple option. K will keep it on the outside, decide not to pitch it to the receiver. K in the open field, and K walks in untouched. 11-yard touchdown. 30-3 lead. Brendan Kay, absolutely masterful performance here in today's game, minus the interception. The double move on that safety. I told you guys, that's a beautiful move to pull in the open field. And Kay, he's going to bust out the Tebow. I'm pulling out the cooking dance. Kay's busting out the Tebow. We are doing all of these copyrighted moves, and we're going to get in trouble for it eventually. But so far, so good. I'm not even upset. Big win here against SMU, our conference leader. This should put us in first place, I believe, if everything goes the way we want it to outside of today's game in our conference. Brendan Kay, player of the game, over 300 yards, 4 touchdowns. Not a bad performance at all. The guy was pretty solid in today's game. Final score 31-10, so a big statement game in our conference. And maybe this will help us crack the top 25. I mean, a 5-game win streak. We're doing pretty well. Offense is playing pretty outstanding the past couple of weeks. Brendan Kay, 264 through the air, 3 touchdowns, sacked 3 times, which isn't great because a lot of those were his fault. Kay on the ground, 17 for 65 yards. Green was 7 for 23. Abernathy was 7 for 30. And then through the air, 15 receptions, 165 yards, 2 touchdowns, a little unbalanced. And look at the blocking, 3 pancakes delivered in today's game. That's more than any offensive lineman. And then checking out the stats in today's game, on the ground, 118 yards. SMU kept to negative 2 yards on the ground. Our defense was not letting SMU run the ball, although they only ran the ball 3 times, which is kind of weird. They were 33% on third downs. We were 69% in the red zone. We were 62. I mean, this could have been a better game from SMU to make things a little more interesting. I'm not sure what happened. But up next, in week number 12, we're taking on the Rutgers Scarlet Knights, another conference opponent. Rutgers 4-4 on the year, but we're back on the road against a conference opponent. We all know how that went earlier this year against USF, who's actually number 5 in our conference. They're 4-4, 3-1 in the conference. We are currently number 1, and my apologies, I spoke a little too soon. We are now in a 4-game win streak. This is what happens when you have to re-edit videos like 5 times because they're too long. But look at this. I mean, we haven't cracked the top 25 yet. Louisville is actually behind us, and they're still getting votes to get into the top 25, and we're not. But check this out. Finally, a skill upgrade for speed is now at 88, as I'm going to try to bust that out in today's game against Rutgers. Their defense is pretty good against the run. Not great against the pass. We'll have to see if we can continue our pass success in this game. But we have to limit turnovers, obviously. So here we are getting things started on the road in New Jersey. And check it out, it's snowing. We busted out the all-white jerseys. We're going to be blending in like camouflage in today's game against Rutgers. Hopefully it works for us. But the first play of the game, a 4-yard completion to Blake Gannon on the outside. We'll come to the field here, 4 wide set, 2nd and 6. As K is going to drop back to pass. This ball's thrown my way. It's caught in midfield, and it's going to be a foot race as there's only one man to beat, 20-15, 10-5, and he will not get there. Touchdown, Bearcats. We go 76 yards on the second play of the game. And Brendan K gets credit for the longest pass, quote-unquote, in NCAA football history. That was a 76-yard bomb that was really more my doing than Brendan Kay. You'll see it here on the play. That pass was severely underthrown. I wanted this one down the left sideline. This pass thrown too far inside. I made a beautiful adjustment to come back inside, catch that pass, and look at this. The defender's hand went through my body, nearly knocked the football away, but it went off my chest. It went right back into my hand. That's EA Sports for you, but this pass, what a catch, and what a run after the catch. If I didn't have 88 speed, if I was still stuck with 85 speed, that would not have been a touchdown. I can guarantee you that. I barely got in. That plus 3 speed just barely did it for me. So we go up 7-0. Rutgers ties it up. It's 7-7 as this kick will be returned from about the 9-yard line. Bring this one up the field and trying to see if we can get this ball back down the field for another touchdown, as this one might be going back on the kick return but push out of bounds after a 44-yard return. And we'll get this one started from past midfield. It's 1st and 10. K drops back, fires my way once again, and another completion. Good for 22 yards, getting us down to the 25-yard line. What a hot start for this offense through the air in today's game. Rutgers, like you saw earlier, didn't have the best pass defense, and we're attacking their weakness. Haven't run the ball yet in today's game. 1st down and 10, slant routes as K is going to try to fire outside for the receiver, and that will be the first incompletion as he was hit as he was throwing, and that's going to make this 2nd and 10 from the 25. We'll go to the ground game. Draw play up the middle for Abernathy, and Abernathy, good for 4 yards, and that's going to make it 3rd down and six. So a big third down here, trying to go up in this game, as we don't want to settle for three. Pass caught here for the first down. That's good for 8 yards, getting us down inside the 15-yard line, as I already have 100 yards receiving in today's game. First and 10, draw up the middle for Abernathy. He's going to find some yardage. That's good for 10 yards, making a second and inches from inside the 5-yard line. Big time play there by Abernathy. Second and inches. I'm off the field for some reason, as we'll go read option. And it's going to be Brendan Kay cutting up the field. 4-yard touchdown as we'll take the lead right back, 14-7 here in this first quarter. Our offense showing no signs of slowing down, but neither is Rutgers. They tie the game back up at 14 here in the second quarter inside of 4 minutes. Up the ground with Abernathy again. That carry is good for 11, so our run game is pretty efficient here so far against this pretty talented run defense of Rutgers, but our offensive line, the false start, backs us up 5 yards, and that'll make it first and 15 as we're back at our own 45-yard line. Kay's going to drop back here, fire outside. This one is caught by Alex Chisholm, good for 6 yards, making a second down and 9. And after a 1-yard gain by Abernathy out there on the ground, it's going to make it third down and 8 inside of 3 minutes. Kay's going to drop back to pass. Time to throw, fires left side for, that's going to be Chris Moore. He's got 8 yards on the first down as this drive will continue. So later in the drive, looking at second and 12, 2-minute warning approaching. Not like there's a 2-minute warning, but this pass underthrown by Kay, come on. Throw the ball down the field, overthrow the football for once. It's intercepted by TJ Johnson, and Rutgers will have the ball at the 45-yard line with 2 minutes left. They spend under a minute with the football, get a touchdown. We're down by 7, 21-14 lead for Rutgers, but we still have 3 timeouts to work with. Plenty of time to move the ball down the field, but an incomplete pass there by Kay will not help get this ball down the field. Minute 16 left in the first half. Kay fires right side down sideline for McClung, and McClung in the open field, and he's brought down by Johnson. This guy has great recovery speed, but we have the ball inside the 20-yard line. I mean, they gave him a free release on the outside. McClung, I don't know how he gets caught on this play. I mean, Johnson is trailing at least 10, 15 yards when that ball is thrown and somehow catches up with McClung. But here we are, first and 10, running a read option, taking out the corner, and it's going to be a carry up the middle, and Abernathy finishes off the drive. He goes 12 yards up the middle, untouched, did what McClung couldn't do, and that's just outrun the defense. But the blocking here in this first half by the offensive line and the receivers has been fantastic. But Rutgers, they go down the field with that little bit of time remaining in the first half. They get a field goal up 24-21 here in the second half. Second and 10, Kay fires right side for Teon Green. This pass is caught for a first down as this drive will continue. Third down and 14, big third down conversion we need to get this, as Kay fires downfield and another underthrown football. Put some air under the pass, that's all I'm asking for. I made a beautiful adjustment, ran past the defense. I saw where the hole in the zone was, and Kay can't put air under the football. That should have been picked off, honestly. But we're lucky it wasn't, but our defense gets a stop, finally stopping Rutgers. This pass here will be caught for a couple yards, and I'm still on my feet. Finally brought down after a gain of 7, but another record has been broken. 88 receptions on the season. The previous record was 87 on the year. I mean, either I'm just being a beast, or there haven't been a lot of great receivers coming out of the University of Cincinnati. Second down and 3, Kay steps back, rifles this one down the field for McClung, and McClung has to lay out for the catch, but that's a big first down, making it first down and goal. Another free release on the outside, safety not paying attention to McClung once again. It's got to be these white uniforms, but how do you not catch and run with that football? And somehow I get pulled off the field, so it's going to be first and goal. We'll go to the ground up the middle on the draw. That carry good for a couple yards, getting us down to about the 3-yard line. It's going to be second and goal, and we're going to probably bust out another read option on this carry or on this play. And it's going to be an inverted veer up the middle, and Kay has the touchdown to increase our lead. 4 yards once again for Brennan Kay, and the blocking once again perfect. This is what we have to do, but Rutgers has not given up yet. Fourth quarter approaching, down by 3, 28-31. We've got to get something going here on this drive. Kay's going to drop back, he'll fire short. This one's caught by Abernathy. That's good for about 7 yards on the short completion, and that's going to make this second down and 3. 30 seconds left, trying to get one more big play before the fourth quarter. This pass going to be caught by McClung running across the middle of the field on the slant. That's good for a first down, getting us past midfield. And here we are in the fourth quarter. It's crunch time for this Bearcats offense. We have to take the lead and hope our defense can stop Rutgers, and maybe we'll take a two-score lead. It's going to be third and two after that completion to the outside, and we're going to... Oh, my gosh, we're running a wide receiver quick. Why are we running this play? We haven't run this all season. Now you want to run it on a crucial third down, and we'll lose 2 yards. There was nothing I could do about that. The blocking just wasn't there. I didn't want to go back and lose even more yards. So now it's going to be fourth down and four as we have to go for it on this play. This drive has to continue. We're not in field goal range yet, and a pass by Brennan Kay over the middle to Abernathy. It's good for the first down. This drive will continue, and we'll go right back to the same play. I know Rutgers is running cover two. They've been running it this entire game. Can I just get this ball in open space, and can it not be underthrown? As I have plenty of room this time, this ball is caught, and we're down inside the 10-yard line. It's first down and goal. Big-time throw, big-time play. This drive will continue. We are threatening to score once again, but I'm off the field. Every time we get in the red zone, I get pulled off the field, but the pass caught by McClung coming from the left to the inside is caught for a near touchdown. What trickery will we bust out this time? Will it be an inverted veer? Will it be a read option? We'll have to see. Is Rutgers going to be ready? Another read option by Kay, and Rutgers is ready. We'll lose 2 yards on the play. It's going to be third down and goal, and I'm still not on the field. We'll come to the field. Jumbo set as Kay's going to drop back out of the play action pass, and this one's going to be thrown short for Dowdy, and it's a touchdown. That's going to be our third string tight end with the touchdown that gives us the lead. Number 81 barely gets any playing time. Nice catch, nice touchdown, and the late tackle happened again, but it really doesn't matter. But what does matter is our defense not being able to stop Rutgers in this game. It's getting out of hand. Rutgers, 520 yards in today's game. We need a big kick return, and this could be the one that gets me on the board with touchdowns on the season, but I'm going to be tackled just short of just really being able to break that punt or kick return loose. I mean, this one taken all the way back to, I believe, the Rutgers 35-40-yard line, and really, I mean, it just came down to a couple of speedsters tracking me down, and we'll get started here on offense. First down and 10, ball is at the 30. We'll go four wide as Kay's going to drop back the pass, trying to run with the football. Kay, get rid of the football. Second and 14, we'll come to the field in the five wide set, minute 12 left. Kay, you have to get rid of this football on time. We do not have time for your little dazzling plays. And Kay taking off the run, and he fumbles the football, and it's luckily recovered by McClung. This got so close to being game over for the Bearcats. I was talking about this all in the last game. Kay, you need to stop running into the fender. Slide short. And this time, Johnson nearly forced the football loose, but it's going to be a beautiful recovery. Is that ball literally just hopped into the hands of Anthony McClung? Nearly recovered by a Scarlet Knight, but we got the job done. And this drive will very luckily continue. We still have a chance to take the lead and win this game. First and 10, four wide set. Once again, trips to the right side of the field, running across the middle. This pass is caught, and I'll get popped after a gain of 6 yards, and we'll call a timeout. Probably should have stopped short because that would get me injured on the play, and that would bring up second and 14. Will we go read option once again? No, this time K will drop back the pass, and it's Chris Moore right across the middle for the touchdown. I honestly would have liked to burn a little more clock, but we take the lead here with a little time left in the game. All we have to do is hope that our defense can stop Rutgers with 39 seconds left. Rutgers down by 4 points. They can't settle for three. They're getting started from about the 25-yard line. That's passed on outside. This one is caught by the tight end, and that will get them about 7 yards. That will actually end up stopping the clock. 34 seconds left, and Rutgers will make a formation shift. Quarterback drop it back to pass. Pressure. This pass is dropped. That brings up third and three with 31 seconds left. It's going to be four down territory the rest of the way for Rutgers as they're down by four. So we need two stops. Quarterback drops back the pass. Plenty of time to throw. Rifles down the left sideline. And this pass is caught over the top of the defense. And Rutgers scores a touchdown to take the lead with 23 seconds left. Why are we running single safety high with this amount of time left in the game? And what's even worse is that the safety went to that side of the field and we still got beat down the field. What in the world is our defense doing? But we're only down by three. We still have two timeouts. We need a big kick return here. to get us back down the field. If I can get us back down near the 30, that would be great. But this return is taking it back to about the 41-42-yard line. We have 19 seconds left. That's plenty of time for this offense. We've been passing the ball pretty well this entire game. There's going to be a bad press on the outside. This pass is thrown quickly by Kay. That's caught for the first down. And an unfortunate injury is I'm going to have to sit out the rest of this game on the sideline. The injury BS, the injury cheese, whatever you want to call it, has struck here late in the game against Rutgers in the most crucial moment. And Kay, why are you running? Get back to the line. Spike the football. We don't have time for this. Second and five. And I almost rage quit right here. I was like, I can't believe this is happening. Like, this game went down to the final seconds, and I finally decided to just let this play out. 1 second left, and we barely get the spike off in time. Third down and five. 1 second left. We have to Hail Mary the ball down the field. K fires down the sideline. This pass is incomplete, and we will lose in week 12. What a frustrating ending to this game. Our defense failing us in the final seconds. I can't believe it. And the injury BS, the injury cheese, really kept me off the field in the most crucial time. I mean, if you think about it, we could have maybe gone no huddle against, you know, Rutgers when we, with that first completion on that final drive, we could have kept running with that five wide verticals down the field that entire time and hopefully gotten down the field and not had to burn that first time out following the injury. And I mean, I really can't blame our offense. Our defense was terrible. 5-12 through the air, giving up 4 touchdowns, 1 with pretty much no time left in the game. I mean, what a great start to this game. 76 yards through the air, just burning Rutgers down the field in our second play of the game. Then the kick return, then that 22-yard completion. And it seemed like everything was going our way. And that's when I kind of figured things were going to go wrong for us later in the game. Normally, when we have a hot start like that, things just tend to go south very quickly. And unfortunately, it just fell apart due to our defense. So we lose this game 45-42. I mean, run game wasn't great. Abernathy had a 5.5-yard average. I was 1 carry for negative 1 yards off that wide receiver quick run. And ball was pretty spread out. I mean, I had 8 catches, 157 yards. Anthony McClung was 5 for 130. Chris Moore, 3 for 21. Chisholm, 2 for 14. Annan, 1 for 4. Dowdy, 1 for 4 in the touchdown. And Tion Green, 1 for 15. And then Abernathy was 1 for 13. But, I mean, 600 yards pretty much given up by our defense in today's game. 83 on the ground, 5-12 through the air. I mean, they just let Rutgers do whatever they wanted in today's game, and that has to stop. Our defense needs to be more consistent. And that interception, it did hurt us because, Kay, that pass was underthrown. That should have been a touchdown. This game would have been much different. But look at our defense. Look what they did in today's game. That's 3 receivers with over 100 yards in this game. That's 2 starters and their slot receiver tearing us apart in today's game. So we lose, we're back to 8-2. So all our progress over the last couple of weeks has pretty much been lost. And now we're going up against 7-3 Houston. And this is another big conference game for us, and it's on the road. I mean, we just cannot play well against big conference opponents. And right now we're moving back to number 3 as USF, the Bulls, have moved up to number 1, Houston ahead of us at number 2. We're now number 3, Rutgers is now number 7. So this is going to be a big game for us in week 13. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. Like if you enjoy, subscribe if you want to see more. I should be pumping these out more consistently now that I'm kind of done with E3 coverage. But thanks for watching, guys. See you later. Thanks for watching.